from Hollywood. The heart of the entertainment world. The Hollywood Palace. With your host, George Burns. Tonight, the Gaonas, the Greenwood County Singers, Rich Little, Wayne Newton, Prassana Rao, Connie Stevens, the Zacchini X-15 Rocket, Mitchell Ayers of the Hollywood Palace Orchestra, all brought to you by Schlitz, the great light beer with gusto, the beer that made Milwaukee famous simply because it tastes so good, and by Consolidated Cigar Corporation, makers of Dutch Master cigars. Step up to the fine cigar, Dutch Masters. We'll return to the Hollywood Palace after a word from one of our sponsors.
You know what this country needs is a good free cigar. Well, you can have a free Dutch Masters Panatella on me. Now keep watching and see how you can get it.
Take advantage of this terrific deal. Look for this special 5-pack. And get 5 Dutch Masters Panatella cigars for the price of 4. You get the 5th one free. That's a free cigar on Danny Thomas. Dutch Masters Panatella is the extra long Panatella, made with tobaccos that are married for mildness and flavor. It's a cigar you'll really enjoy. Look for this special display of Dutch Masters Panatellas at your cigar counter. The display with Danny Thomas's picture on it. Pay for 4 Dutch Masters Panatellas, 50 cents, and get the 5th Panatella free.
Step up to a fine cigar. Have a Dutch Masters Panatella on me.
And now, from the Hollywood Palace, here is your host, the star of Wendy and Me, George Burns!
Mitch, one more time, and this time in my key. How do, Mr. and Mrs. Audience? It is now my time to perform the evolution of dance I'll show to you in style, originality, and form. There are dances that have been the rage and some that didn't last. And tonight we will review for you the present and the past. The old folks will remember, and they never can forget, a dance that we will start with, the old-fashioned minuet. And here is one you will remember. It never had any faults. It was loved by everybody. The old-fashioned waltz. You will remember, it started back in 1817. That Russian and Polish mazurka, Professor Lazarine. Yeah. Here is one that I recall. It always was a treat. Valentino's tango. It had that slinky beat. Then came the one step. Black Bottom. Charleston. What Tuesday? And now for our finish, bring on the boys. And now for our finish. Now for our finish. We've got none.
Your dressing rooms and relax. I know you've worked hard. You know, I got those dances from Fred Astaire. He was glad to get rid of them. The girls I got from Georgia Jessel. He wasn't glad to get rid of them. And then years ago, I did a dancing act with a girl, Burns and Ross, and we had a sensational finish. My partner, Betsy, used to wave the American flag that she made herself. We've got a wonderful show for you tonight. One of the things you're going to see later is the amazing Zacchini. He shoots two people out of a rocket over 100 feet through the air. But right now, you're going to meet a terrific trampoline act from Mexico. With one of the members is the youngest member that ever performed on a trampoline. And here they are, the Gaonas. Little Richie Gaona, 7 years old. I think they put Mexican jumping beans in his milk.
My kid brother, he's a lazy kid. One day's work is all the work he did. Wrote a song entirely wrong, up in Yonkers, it is going strong.
That's one of my big hits. I made a record of that song years ago. I sang on one side, and there was an apology by Thomas Edison on the other.
George M. Cohen and the other gang heard my brother when the song he sang. He said that it cannot miss, it's bound to be a hit.
You know, I've been singing all my life. You know, when I was first born, the doctor kept slapping me, but I wouldn't stop. I finished two choruses of Ain't Misbehaving. Then when I started to sing in the Heart of a Cherry, they turned the heat off in my incubator. It's a good thing I was smoking a cigar, I'd have froze to death. You know, the reason I'm not recognized as one of the great singers is that I never had a gimmick. You know, something that people talk about, like Dean Martin's drinking. Now, Dean Martin walks on the stage and he sings a song with a drink in his hand. And he'll be a star as long as his liver holds out. Now, when they make a picture, the minute they want somebody that drinks, they hire Dean Martin. And he's a smash in all of these pictures. Now he takes about 40 or 50 drinks a day. Not because he likes it, he wants to stay warmed up. If the right part comes along, he's ready. I saw him last night, and boy, was he ready. He was under a table rehearsing his next picture. Phil Harris was under there, too, trying to steal the part away from him. Who do you think got it? Lawrence Welk. He doesn't drink, but those champagne bubbles make it look like he does. But that's his gimmick, champagne bubbles. And there's Bing Crosby. He's got a reputation for living up to being a father. That's not easy work at his age. But that show business, Bob Hope is known for his energy, and Crosby's doing all the work. Look, Bob Hope has four kids. That's not bad for a fellow who's never home. And Jack Benny's gimmick is being stingy. And that's not true. When I played Las Vegas, Jack Benny came on to see me. And the minute he saw the crap table, he ran over to the table and he grabbed the dice. In fact, they were still talking about it the next day. Do you know that he held the dice for 1 hour and 45 minutes? Finally, he threw them and rolled a crap. Lost a dollar and somebody had to hold him for an hour and 45 minutes. And there's Jane Mansfield, who nobody can hold for an hour and 45 minutes. Ethel Merman, who was married for an hour and 45 minutes. And there's Zsa Zsa Gabor. You know, her gimmick is glamour and sex appeal. And we did a television show together, and we were supposed to play a love scene together. And I went up to her apartment to rehearse the scene, and I played it for real. I wanted to see if this gimmick works. I put my arms around her, and I hugged her, and I squeezed her, and I kissed her, and she sat there, just looked at me and laughed. She's got a great sense of humor, but no sex appeal. I'm lucky it turned out that way. At my age, I even get tired when I hold on to my electric toothbrush. Where was I? Is that a dirty kiss? How can it miss? How can it miss? How can it miss? When the chorus goes like this, pack up your sins and go to the devil in Hades. You'll find the finest gentlemen and the finest ladies. They'd rather be down below than up above. Hades is full of thousands of Jones, Browns, Hooligans, Cones, and Bradys. They got a wonderful tune that went to the devil because those jazz bands put a trick in it, a little kick in it, a reggae pick in it. We got a couple of old reformers in heaven making you go to bed at 11. Pack up your sin, go to the devil, and you never have to go to bed at all. But that's it. Just so you don't think that I'm doing all the vocals around here, we'll be right back with the Greenwood County Singers.
with a glass of Schlitz, a friendly glass of Schlitz, real gusto in a great light beer.
The beer that made Milwaukee famous simply because it tastes so good.
Here they are, those record breakers of the record business, the Greenwood County Singers. Let's have it.
Like great big man, I'm gonna go tell another what I think about it. Say thank you, ma'am, for giving me your daughter Anne. She sure is stacked from her toes to the pretty little nape of her neck. She's packed like a seed in a grape. She's smooth as marble skin. When I see her, I believe I'm a real young guy. And every time I go to work, I think I might die if I had hurry home again. If the good Lord worked all night at making me a female plan, I'd say no thanks, Lord. I'll just keep Anne. If I come home feeling like I've been run all over by a 10-ton truck, she can rub my shoulder and ease my aches and pains. If I lose my job and I'm down to a silver dollar and I feel like a dried-up board in a holler, she cools my brow like summer rain. If the good Lord worked 100 years of making me a female plan, I'd say no thanks, Lord. I'll just keep Anne. I'd say no thanks, Lord. I'll just keep Anne.
Your kids sing great.
Thank you.
Wonderful sound. Let's do something together. B flat. All right. Make it pretty now.
Boom. Congela por non me va el mubalo tu va je vois la vie en rose. Boom. El mudi de moda mode mode tu les joies jamais quelque chose. Boom. Et entre dans ma gonne, pas du bonheur, je vois qu'on est la cause. C'est elle pour moi, moi pour elle dans la vie. Elle me l'a dit la journée pour la vie. Et dès que je l'aperçois, elle ose sans se voir ma gueule. Et dès que je l'aperçois, elle ose sans se voir ma gueule.
I forgot the finish. But they didn't. Thank you.
My khaki belt? I just thought of it. And now a great artist.
Somebody who does a beautiful act just with his hands. Of course, Gene Kelly made a fortune with his feet, and Charles Boyer made a fortune with his dreamy eyes, and then there's Jane Mansfield with his lovely blonde hair. Can you imagine her on the trampoline? She ever went up, she'd never come down. Now I want you to meet a talented artist. He's from India, and this is his first appearance in the United States. So let's welcome Prassana Rao.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to present you a few portraits of well-known world personalities. These portraits have been selected to emphasize some special features. Like, I start with the mustache, Joseph Stalin. Nikita Khrushchev. Charles de Gaulle. The late Prime Minister of India, respected Nehru. The great honored citizen of America and United Kingdom, Sir Winston Churchill. President beloved John F. Kennedy.
Each of these houses, a woman is washing her face. Meet the soap user. She gets her face clean, but her skin often feels taut and dry. Here's the cold cream user. She has soft skin, but her skin can feel greasy and sticky afterward. Now this lady is getting her face clean as with soap, soft as with cream, because she's using Noxzema skin cream. What a refreshing tingle as Noxzema medicates while it cleans. Noxzema washes off with water because it's greaseless. Leaves skin soap clean, but not soap dried. Cream soft, but with no greasy cream leftovers. And Noxzema is medicated to help heal and prevent surface blemishes. So start getting your skin soap clean, yet cream soft. Get tingling refreshment. See radiant results. Use Noxzema. It does more for your skin than any soap or cosmetic cream can.
Now, Wayne Newton, a young boy who's the singing sensation of the country, and nothing is going to stop him.
But I'm going to try.
Here he is, Wayne Newton singing his new hit record.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we had a special request to do a Bolivian folk song. So that's exactly what we're going to do, and it sounds like this. Let's cook it one time. You've never been to Bolivia. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna translate this song and do it in English. Haba Nagila in English. And it sounds like this. Here we go, one time. Hey now, won't you come home with me? Won't you come on home? I cried that whole night song, yeah, yeah. I'm gonna do the cooking, hey, I'm gonna pay that rent. I know I done you wrong. Little honey, do you remember that rainy evening that I threw you out with nothing but a fine two-comb? Yeah, child, honey, I know that you're playing. Ain't that a doggone lemon shake, baby? Won't you please come home? Yeah, baby, won't you come home, baby? Won't you come home? I cried and I cried and I moaned and I cried and I moaned and I cried the whole night long. I'm gonna do the cooking, hey, I'm gonna pay that rent. Cause I know I done you wrong. Little honey, do you remember that rainy evening that I threw you out with nothing but a fine two-comb? Let's do it faster. I know you're playing. Ain't that a kick in the head? Feel better, won't you please come home? You go. Won't you come home, baby? Won't you come on home? I cried that whole night long, yeah, yeah. I'm gonna do the cooking, hey, I'm gonna pay that rent. Cause I know I've done you wrong. Well, honey, do you remember that rainy evening that I threw you out with nothing but a bad Tacoma? Hey, I know you're to blame. Ain't that a doggone lemon chain? Feel better, won't you join me one time?
I'm not sure. I think you're a hit. Wayne, you're absolutely marvelous.
Thank you very much, Mr. Burns. Thank you.
Ask you, how old are you?
I'm 22.
How many records have you sold?
3 million.
We're both in the same league. I'm 3 million years old and sold 22 records. Let me ask you something. Where did you get this singing style?
Well, I have a confession to make, Mr. Burns. I must admit that I've learned an awful lot from watching the real old-timers.
You did, huh?
Yes, sir. Paul Anka, Frankie Avalon.
Well, Wayne, I'd love to sing with you, but unfortunately, I can't.
Why not?
Your manager asked me not to. We have lots more show for you at the Hollywood Palace, and we'll be right back with Rich Little, Connie Stevens, and the great Zacchini with his X-15 rocket. Stick around, it's all for free. I thought I'd mention that Jack Benny is watching the show. Welcome back to the second half of the Hollywood Palace show. And I was outside watching Zacchini get his rocket ready for the countdown, and maybe you'd like to see some of the preparations. Let's go outside for a minute. Looks like we have a full house outside, too. That's Zacchini, and the two people he's going to shoot out of the rocket. They're a son and daughter. Now get ready for one of the cleverest young fellas in show business. Rich Little, ladies and gentlemen.
I hear that David Brinkley is planning a new newscast for next season, and I understand he's going to hire some Hollywood stars to make the program more appealing to the masses. So here now is a preview of the all-new David Brinkley Reports. It's news time with David Brinkley and the stars. Now here's David Brinkley in Washington.
Good evening. The top story today concerns this newscast. Last night, Chet Huntley was fired from NBC News. He committed the cardinal sin on this newscast. He forgot to say goodnight, David. Now on with the news. There was an axe murder in New York today, and we have picked the perfect reporter to cover this bloody affair. So come in. New York City.
This is Alfred Hitchcock. I'm standing in the apartment where the murder was committed. And there's blood and gore all over the place. It's beautiful. The axe murderer certainly did a lovely job of the brutal murder. And I do hope the police catch him soon because I want to use him on my show. Now back to David Brinkley in Washington. Good night.
Thank you, Alfie. You're sweet. Turning to politics, we take you now to Bobby Kennedy's headquarters, and our next reporter is none other than Jack Parr.
This is Jack, Jack Parr. It's all true. It's true. I kid you not, you know, because I never lie to you. You know, Bobby Kennedy, and this is true, is a real guy, a person, a man, an American, and I discovered him. And I kid you not, I discovered, you know, a lot of people because I like people, and people, you know, who like me are the luckiest people in the world. Which is all true. Ask Albert Schweitzer. To David Brinkley, and I kid you not, thank you. God love you.
Thank you, Jack, you big cry baby. We take you now to Los Alamos, where there's been a big explosion. And on the scene to report this event is none other than Gregory Peck.
This is Gregory Peck. And I'm all excited. A short time ago, a kitchen stove exploded, blowing a husband and wife through the roof. And it's the first time they've been out together in 20 years. Thank you very much. Now back to David Brinkley.
Thank you, Greg. And finally, in the news, we take you to London, and here is Richard Burton.
Thank you, David. I'm speaking to you from the veranda of our country estate at Pudding on the Thames. I want to make a statement on behalf of my beautiful wife, who's just renounced her United States citizenship. She has asked me to say to you that America is a nice place to visit, but she would never want to love here. Live here. Now back to David Huntley on the Brinkley. Never mind. Thank you.
And that's the news. Good night, Alfie.
Good night.
Good night, Jack.
Good night, David. And remember, I discovered you too.
Good night, Greg.
Good night, Mr. Brinkley.
Good night, Richard.
Good night, David.
And good night, Chet, wherever you are.
Thank you.
Rich, those were great impressions.
Thank you.
But you left out one of the great personalities in show business.
I did?
Yeah, yes, you did.
Oh, sorry.
You know, it really is a tremendous thrill.
Now, that's Jack Benny. I'm thinking of a singer.
A singer?
Fellow that
sings. Yeah. This is Bing Crosby, you know. It's a great joy, you know, and a great thrill to be on the Hollywood Palace show.
This is a fellow that sings a tone higher than Bing. And smokes a cigar.
Groucho smoked?
me. Do me.
Oh, well, let me ask you this question. How's your brother?
Which one do you mean, George?
The one with the appendicitis scar up here in his neck.
No, appendicitis is on the stomach.
I know,
see,
but he was so ticklish they had to operate up there.
Thank you. In a minute, we'll be meeting the prettier half of Wendy and me, Connie Stevens.
your taste. Salem flavor freshens your taste. Smoke Salem cigarettes.
Isn't it time you discovered Salem filter cigarettes? Salem freshens your taste while it brings you full tobacco flavor. Rich tobacco taste, menthol soft flavor. That's Salem.
Salem flavor freshens your taste. Smoke Salem cigarettes.
Salem flavor freshens your taste.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the co-star of my television series. She's young, she's beautiful, she's talented, and she's worth a fortune. I wish she'd marry my son. If I lost my voice, she can take care of both of us. Miss Connie Stevens.
It's not my cup of tea. They won't throw rice at me for a while yet. I have no plan to wed, be resolutely led down the aisle yet. With a smile yet. For the moment I choose to be fancy free. They can throw old shoes, but they can't hit me. I wanna dance until the darkest heavens turn gray, until the dawn strolls in with the day. Then I'll say, don't let the van get away. But matrimony, I'm not ready yet. Married I can always get. I want a guy, an ardent swain who'll gaily pursue. And when he drinks champagne from my shoe, hey, that's my cue to act like a shy ingenue. No wedding gown for this silhouette. Married I can always get. I'll live my life like I'm used to. I'll get a ring when I choose to, because by now I'll find that the nicest rings are on a merry-go-round. I'll be blasé to any man whose motives are base. And keep each wily wolf in his place. Till the chase finally ends up in embrace. But as for wedlock, unlock me, my pet. Married I can always get. I'll live my life like I'm used to. I'll get a ring when I choose to. Because by now I've found that the nicest rings are on a merry-go-round.
Connie, you're absolutely darling.
Oh, thanks, George.
You know, but there's one thing that's been puzzling me, and I'm going to ask you about it. Why did you pick me to play Wendy? You know, that part is silly. I mean, I'm a pretty good dramatic actress, you know.
Well, I picked you the night we were in the restaurant together. Remember, we were there with some people?
Oh, you mean the night the waiter said, do you want any shrimps? And I said, no, I'd rather go out with tall fellows?
That's the night I knew you were a great dramatic actress. Let's do something together.
Okay. Mitch, and Mr. Burns, key, please.
My kid brother, no, that's the other song. What is the song?
Listen.
Oh, yeah, listen to the reggae. I got so many numbers. Listen to the reggae music playing.
It's reminiscent, listen what you miss on that tune, it keeps you swaying.
My, but that music sounds so sweet, I just can't keep still on my feet.
Cause ragtime music to me is a perfect treat, because it can't be beat.
At the ball when you're feeling kind of blue.
Listen and we'll tell you what to do. Commence the dancing. Just start prancing, right and left glancing. A hoochie dancing, sliding glider dancing. Do the tango jiggle with the Texas style. Me wiggle, grab your partner and hold her, like me and Polder. A little bolder. You work your shoulder, snap your fingers, one and all. In the hall, at the ball. In the hall, at the ball, that's all.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Anderson, but he still has a cold. And a sore throat, too.
I can't have my best salesman out much longer. And you tell George to gargle Listerine for that sore throat.
George's boss is right. Gargling Listerine is strongly recommended when you have a cold and a sore throat. But the best remedy for a cold is not to get one. And tests over a 12-year period proved that people who gargled Listerine full strength twice a day had fewer colds, milder colds, and about half as many sore throats as those who did not gargle. Only Listerine, of all leading mouthwashes, contains so many active ingredients to kill germs that come with colds and can cause sore throats. So this winter, gargle with Listerine twice a day, every day, for fewer colds, milder colds.
Our Hollywood Palace Billboard Girl of the Week was selected in a contest conducted by ABC's Minneapolis affiliate, KMSP-TV. Channel 9. She's an airline student, and she was also Miss Minneapolis of 1965. Let's welcome Diane McCrane. Diane?
Sure.
How's everything in Minneapolis?
Well, it was 28 below zero when I left.
I don't know why you took the trip. Our weather here is just like it. Who's on next week's show?
Next week in the Hollywood Palace, Barry Chase, Lei Chin Chi from Paris, Bert Lahr, Julius LaRosa, Jan Murray, Australia's Rob Murray, the death-defying Nerveless Knox.
And, of course, our hostess, Betty Davis. Thank you, Betty. That's pretty good. My son's phone number is Hollywood. Thank you. Is he ready? Okay. The cameras and lights are on, and Zacchini is ready. So let's go outside. It's right next door to the Hollywood Palace for one of the most thrilling spectacles in show business. Zacchini is the only man who's ever shot two people out of a rocket or a cannon at one time. There's his son, Emmanuel, and his daughter, Catherine. They're being loaded into the rocket. If you do an act like that, I'd have to be loaded. Now he's raising the rocket to an angle that will send the human missiles over 100 feet through space. If he had a couple more rockets and a few more children, he could start his own planet. Looks like they're all set. Five,
four, three, two, one.
There they go. Oh, the great Zacchini, isn't he, thrilling? You know, Zacchini reminds me of a story that happened to me years ago. I was playing in a theater in Schenectady, and after my first song, I was canceled, and I didn't have fare to go back to New York. And there was a guy on the bill. He used to shoot another fella out of a cannon. And he helped me. He shot me as far as Newark. But I had to hitchhike the rest of the way. It was very hard to pick up another cannon that time of the night. And don't forget to stay with us. We've got a great finale, and I'll give you a little hint. It's a my key.
Is that cologne on a kitchen shelf? No, new air freshener. Beautiful new Glade Mist. Look, there's no cap. Just press here. Glade Mist sprays where your finger points. Feels cool, fresh. And comes in four delicate new fragrances, each at a new low price. New Glade Mist feels cool as it clears and freshens the air. Try it.
No matter what kind of dust collectors you have, they need Pledge. A dust cloth alone can't remove dirt and smudges, but Pledge cleans and waxes, leaves a protective wax shine that resists spills and spots. For tricky dust collectors, spray Pledge on your dust cloth. Johnson's Pledge, for waxed beauty instantly as you dust, every time you dust, anything you dust.
This is our finale.
Hey there, honey. We haven't got much money. Our cupboard is almost bare. Our clothes are old and funny. Say now, honey, we don't need any money. Tonight we haven't got a care.
You and I are gonna be in high society. We're sure gonna step around.
to the fine spot in town. We don't need parts or diamond rings or all those fancy things. As long as you have me, we're high society.
Get your hat, powder your nose, feed the cat, the window's closed, leave the ashes in the tray, the dishes in the sink, we'll be ready in no wink.
We don't need furs or diamond rings or all those fancy things. As long as you have me, we're on feet.
Next week, and Betty Davis will sing the last note. Now applause.
This portion of the Hollywood Palace has been brought to you by Johnson Wax, makers of beautiful new Glade Mist that feels cool as it clears and freshens the air. And by Listerine, your breath stays fresh because your mouth is clean. Listerine clean. Don't forget, next week at the Hollywood Palace, Barry Chase, Lane Chi-Chi, Bert Lahr, Julius LaRosa, Jan Murray, Rob Murray, the Nerveless Rock, and your hostess, Betty Davis. This is Dick Tufeld speaking.